Yeah, ni bore mare. This is a nice setting.
Yeah.
We are sitting in a very strange place.
Art and culture.
Art and culture. And in front of me is Willy Goyce. The man of many roles. I know him as an artist, as a photographer, as a writer, as a singer, as a composer. What else? Willy. But today we are here to talk about your master's dissertation dealing with...
I did a research on how the design came into the newspapers
in Goa.
In Goa, since the time, you know, right from 1840, I researched newspapers, and I did it in a manner that taking technology into consideration, according to the technology, how the design seeped in.
So one second, this is for your MFA degree?
In Applied Art.
In Applied Art.
Yeah.
Under the Goa University?
No, I did it under the Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University in Aurangabad.
Goa University doesn't have MFA?
No, Goa University does not have
MFA. As of now?
Yeah.
So you looked at the old newspapers?
Yes.
Yeah. And what did you find?
I came across many interesting things. Interesting things like when it was not possible to print photographs by making blocks, they used to paste actual photographs, bromides,
in
the newspapers. I came across this. It was very interesting.
They would print a bromide and photograph and paste it?
And paste it.
How many copies could you get that way?
I don't know. The circulation could have been about 100, 200, 300 maybe. But I came across this newspapers. I also came across, this was in 1901.
Just to interrupt, someone told me that Willy Goyce's dad was a very good block maker in Navin Times.
I learned blocking
in Navin Times. And the person who told me this was our friend Sandeep Naik, who I interviewed a few days back. Sorry for interrupting. That's an aside.
Things like this, when the technology was not very advanced.
Willy, you told me you were impressed by the printing also in those days, although it was not very advanced.
Yes. Yeah.
Design and printing.
Design was limited to all the small, motifs which were ready-made. They had to play around only with those. And there was a stage where even there was no definition of columns as such. That also gradually seeped in.
There was no definition of columns. So what did they do?
Yeah, in the sense like it was
fluid.
A little erratic. Yeah.
Okay. Erratic.
Yeah. It was by the time it was standardized. It was almost in the 1900s.
So a page could have one column, two columns, what, how?
Two columns it could have, three columns it could have.
Yeah.
The columns started narrowing down much later.
Okay.
And I think that there's a science behind that you cannot read a long line and come back this side. It takes a little effort.
Yeah. So, it's hard on the eye.
Yeah. So the smaller, the something, and it must have come somewhere.
Some global realization reached Goa late.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
So which papers did you look at, Willy?
I don't remember right now, but right from...
this is quite some time back now.
Bombayans and Ave Maria and Herald itself, Herald issues are there.
Herald
that time. I'm a little bad
Mostly Bombay papers, because in those days, apart from the Herald, which still runs under different managements, of course...
Yeah.
Apart from that, no paper continues from those times. Many were short-lived.
Yes.
And we had more papers in the diaspora than in Goa.
In fact, I have made a full chart as part of my research. And on that one chart, you get to know for how long each newspaper existed. Nearly 70 newspapers I have researched. Yeah, around 70. And on that one chart, in one glance, I want to propose this chart to the Central Library, which they can enlarge and actually display it. At one glance, you come to know that, if it was some out of just 10 years, some out of just 5 years.
Life
some
of the
was,
papers.
Yeah.
Longevity.
Yeah. Even papers like Bharat to East and all, they're still existing. One started in 1930, 1933.
The librarian Henry Scholberg, who did his PhD on library studies and on Goa and published that bibliography of India Portuguesa and whatever it's called. I was in touch with him by email.
Yeah.
And he sent me a copy of his paper where he describes all the papers that existed in Goa, and he said that 300 existed in this short period.
Yes.
While it's a great number, it also shows that they had limited longevity.
They kept dying. And in fact, it was great to actually handle those newspapers.
Where?
in the archives of Central Library. They are there still. Some of them were very brittle, and I was cautioned to handle them very carefully. Sometimes I used to bump into Maria Lourdes Brav Costa also, and she used to also tell me, "Willy, take care of the papers, you know."
Yeah. So we are one of a kind. If they are lost, they are completely lost.
Because it's our treasure.
Was it difficult to access them?
It was not difficult to access because the staff was very helpful. Yeah.
But all papers may not be here, no? Depending on their politics and censorship.
Yes. That of course.
But since you were looking at design, you're not worried about completeness or touching all of them.
No,
you took representative samples from which era? Which time?
1840 to 1940, about 100 years.
So the history of newspapers in Goa starts at 1820 or 21, I think, somewhere there.
Yes, somewhere around that time. So it was actually that research also opened up a lot of other things.
Like
many of the newspapers were in dual languages. It was Konkani English.
Yeah.
Even
Portuguese Marathi. Portuguese Marathi.
Yeah, Portuguese Marathi came in. Then many other things like. I came across articles on theatrists in those days.
Yeah.
I came across an article when the Abhay Afkariya statue was going to be installed. There were designs invited, and the designs which were, you know, finally approved. You know, sometimes I used to get caught in those. I used to forget design, and I used to get, you know, caught in these aspects.
So for you, design, and for me, the book is an excuse to understand more about Goa.
Yes.
Different aspects of it.
Yes.
So in a way, Willy, this topic, of course, ties up with all your interest, which is Goa, which is writing, which is the literary world, which is design also.
Yeah.
So what prompted you to take it up? Where did you get the idea from?
When I was discussing this with my guide, well, Dr. Govind Pawar was my guide. He was ex-dean of the Aurangabad School of Art. And he had done a research specifically on the advertisements. So
which papers? Marathi?
Marathi papers. So then I said, I am also, like, I have also done work in the press.
Right. You so understand
said,
it.
Yes. He said, he suggested this. And I said, good, I'll go and I'll look at avenues in doing a research in this. And the moment I dived into it,
I realized how deep it was.
Yeah, how deep it was. And I still want, even if I
do your PhD.
PhD, and I have got a lot of material and I can go still deeper in it, provided I get a,
Getting time is the problem. There are only 25 hours in a day, as you and me realize.
Yes.
And how you're busy with teaching and many other things.
Yes, yeah. In fact, now the workload has increased.
What keeps you busy, Willy? Apart teaching, you have more responsibility there?
Teaching, my responsibilities in teaching and a little bit of a lot of administration of the college has come on me also.
As you become senior. What's your post?
Yeah, I'm the second senior most.
In the Goa College of Art.
Goa College. Designation is just assistant professor,
which
is going to be associate professor very soon. And but a lot of this, I have to also look up, after the administration, a large part of the administration. Also.
And apart from that, your innumerable activities, which extend to translation, what else?
Translation, writing. I have to do a lot of reading. We have started the master's degree in the MFA. We have started now, so I am in charge of MFA. So I have to also. Do a lot of preparation for that. One year, this we are in the second year of that.
So the MFA is by papers or by dissertation?
It is by papers.
By papers.
By papers, yeah. Not dissertation.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Are the students well disposed to Goa issues, design issues?
Yeah, right now we have students from Goa.
Yeah.
Now this year one student has joined from Maharashtra.
Yeah.
He has just joined, so I have not exactly.
But they are interested in Goa. They are
looking
at Goa.
Yeah.
What are the fields you feel which need to be researched in design in Goa?
There is a lot. Design, in the sense like right from understanding Goa and Goanness in the design, which is not yet defined,
but
it still has a scope to be defined. A lot of scope is there to be defined. We say like we can't discard Indo-Portuguese design also. That also can come over here in the design. And we also have to look at the international design. That also we are getting because we cannot go backwards.
Yeah.
We have to take our traditional and move ahead with the new designs which are coming.
Plus different language traditions also, no?
Yeah. Yeah, different.
Romi has its own tradition of small papers, Bombay-driven papers. What would you say?
Yes.
On design?
Yeah. in a sense, like, I don't know whether the designs which were brought by them was, it was a conscious effort, but it was, it had to be done basically to compete with the other newspapers also. So somewhere they realized that my newspaper also has to look appealing visually.
I see.
So that is when all these things started coming out. I came across one newspaper, in fact, even they tried printing in gold.
Which one?
It was in somewhere 1904 or something. I don't remember the exact date.
My goodness.
But there was a New Year greeting message in the newspaper, which was in gold, and that is still there.
Wow.
Yeah. They must have done it in the technology which is available then, but that gold color was still there. And I still have all the photographs with me,
I have used them.
Book published?
We won't talk about embarrassing things, because I know we have discussed this in the past, but I hope it does come out because it's such an important issue.
Yeah.
But while they were dealing with looking good on the stands, they also had these constraints of working in a small market, having limited resources and all that.
Yes. I could not make out in the thing.
It's not stated. We'll never know what went into their accounts and their balance sheets and if they were maintained at all.
There were some newspapers which there were no advertisements. There were some newspapers which the advertisement space was kept blank.
I see.
And it was written over there, reserved for advertisement. And the newspaper was published with that blank space. Maybe it was a suggestion for advertisers that, you know, you can advertise in newspapers. I've come across such because advertisement is the main revenue.
Really, amche kobar korche poili mashe ek shabda ache romance che ulaitolo. The romance novels which are called romances, which are basically novels or potboilers or you know, quickies or whatever you want to call them, that were written by people like Reginald Fernandez and Karida Damasian and all these. Mashe, you'll tell us something about that. You read them when you were a kid?
My father used to read. So I have read, but I can't say which I have read. Because I think in those days, we were not supposed to read. So I used to steal when my father
used to
read.
They were kind of adult-like? Little bit?
No, Reginald was not adult-like, but I don't know what, maybe they didn't want us to read.
It spoils your language or focus on English or something.
Yeah, something. I don't know what was the reason, but my father used to read, and he used to fall asleep with the book. I used to take it and read. So I don't remember which I have read, but that actually got me into reading. But then finally I read, I managed to read two of Reginald's, Perdid. Perdid I have read, but I don't remember. Perdid came much later, just before he died. And Bonaventure I have read.
Tija
Morna Upran, Jimmy, Jania Sally.
He was more later, no? 80s, 80s.
Yeah,
yes.
80s,
maybe early 90s.
And the difference is that Reginald was romance.
Yeah.
A little bit fantasy.
Okay.
When it came to Bonaventure, it was, you know,
realistic crime.
Yes. Like Tija Morna Uprand is really gripping, you know. Even
it
Jimmy,
could be true. It could be.
Yeah. And that sort of thing. Even Jania Chelli was quite a gripping.
But they were bestsellers in those days, widely popular, spreading the language.
Yeah, in those days, because my mother-in-law, before I got married, I came to know this later, my wife told me that she used to travel from Sankirni to Mapsa
to buy,
especially Reginald, because Thursday or something was one day on which they used to come, and she would buy and she would bring. And then after she read, it used to circulate.
So I read somewhere that Damasian Karidad would come out with a new book every Wednesday.
Yeah.
Once a week. It was almost a weekly thing.
Yeah.
How he did it, don't ask me.
Yeah,
it's particularly amazing.
Yeah.
Just last week, another of our writers from the world of Marathi, Gurunath Naik.
Gurunath Naik
passed away. And Gurunath Naik has written like something 1207 or 11 or something like that. All these, you know, quickies, potboilers and crime novels. Which don't get mentioned anywhere in any discussion on Goan writing. No, I mean, they are pulp fiction, there's no doubt about it. But these are writers. These are writers who had big markets.
In fact, Reginald was like that. No, even of course when Bonaventure had to struggle, But coming back to my mother-in-law, she had so much such a collection of it, but unfortunately, Sankli used to be flooded, and their house, part of their house was always, every year used to be flooded, and most of those books were destroyed there.
What a sad story. Yeah. What a sad story. And on that note, I think we must end our discussion just to leave us and our readers thinking about the fate of the future of literature in Goa tomorrow.
Have to preserve, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Willie. All the best, and keep up your good work.